So, guys, what do you want to do today?
I made a portal gun.
Anything you want to do, Joseph?
Nah, what about you, dude?
I made a portal gun.
We could watch TV.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
I made a portal gun.
What are you talking about, Cody?
This, it's a portal gun.
What's that?
It's a portal gun.
What's it do?
It opens portals. It can take you to any time and any place, any universe.
Wait, so if I want to go back in time and see a dinosaur, I can?
Yup.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah-huh.
Then prove it.
Okay, move out of the way.
Whoa!
Dude, what's that?
It's a portal, Joseph. Were you not listening?
No.
Go inside it.
Dude, I'm not going in that. What if I die?
Well, go after your hat.
No, not my hat.
Go get it.
It's not fair.
Wait, Cody, where are we?
I think we're in prehistoric times, Junior.
What's more important is, where's my hat, dude?
Yeah, Cody, where's his hat?
I don't know. It could be literally anywhere.
Well, we're not leaving until we find it.
All right, Cody, you look that way. I'll look this way.
Okay.
Where could it be?
Junior?
What?
There's that dinosaur you wanted to see.
Oh, cool, a dinosaur!
No, Junior is gonna see. Oh, no! Oh! Oh!
Ah! Ah! Cody, shoot a portal!
Okay.
Dude, that demon has my ass!
Just bring it where I am! Junior, that was too close.
The dinosaur almost killed us!
Hey, give me my hat back!
What? The caveman came with us, Cody!
Oh, I guess I'll just have to send him back. Oh, no.
What?
Well, the portal gun's out of juice.
Well, change the batteries.
No, I mean, like, literally juice. Like, it runs on apple juice.
Apple juice?
Yeah.
Well, why does it run on apple juice? Why not batteries?
Well, because apples are, like, the only fuel that can power a portal gun.
What?
Well, listen, man, you can make a battery out of potatoes, so screw off. The dinosaur, what's he doing here? He must have come through the portal before it closed, but why was he behind the couch for so long? It's almost like he was waiting there until I said that the portal gun was out of juice so we wouldn't be able to send it back, and we're just three kids and he's a dinosaur, so what are we even gonna do?
Run! What do we do? What do we do?
Let's hide him in the closet. Oh, he's over here. Over here.
Okay, he's trapped in there. Oh, thank God.
Hey.
What?
And it just went off.
Oh, I had a little bit of juice left and you wasted it?
Come on, dude!
Sorry, guys.
So, Cody, what do we do now? We have a dinosaur locked in the closet and a caveman right here.
Well, we just need more apple juice so we can send them back.
We don't have to send the caveman back.
But yes, we do, Junior. He's dangerous. We can't take something from the past. It might affect the future. Like, what if this caveman's children's 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 children is like Albert Einstein or something? Okay, maybe not this caveman's children's 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 children. And he's eating my hair, so that's another reason he can't stay. Oh, hider, Daddy.
Ooh. Okay, so all we have to do is go ask Sheppy for more apple juice, and then we can send him back.
Yeah, let's go.
All right, let's go.
Come on, whatever your name is.
Oh, we have to name him!
We don't have to name him, he's just gonna leave eventually.
I like the name Doo-Doo Man.
What, Doo-Doo Man?
Yeah, you like Doo-Doo Man?
Oh yeah, I like it, it fits.
Come on, Doo-Doo Man.
Can't wait to eat some flambé chips! Oh yeah!
Wait, Chef, do we have any apple juice?
Check the refrigerator, Junior, God!
What was wrong with him?
Junior, he's a caveman. He's never seen fire before.
Wait, Joseph, are you okay?
I'm okay, dude.
Well, let's go check on Doo-Doo Man.
You know what? I'm not even going to ask.
Doo-Doo Man, are you okay? Okay.
Well, maybe if we show him fire isn't bad, he'll calm down.
All right.
Doo-Doo Man. No, it's okay. Doo-Doo Man, look, fire, nice. Fire.
Yeah, it's warm.
Yes, good. Yes, fire.
Really. Don't touch it.
Don't touch it. Doo-Doo Man. I'm sorry. Help me! Get him off of me!
Okay, look, we need to teach Doo-Doo Man how to talk because he can't understand us, and we could have told him that fire would have burned him.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
So I'm gonna get some cue cards so we can teach Doo-Doo Man how to talk.
You okay, Doo-Doo Man?
Okay, Doo-Doo Man, I got these word cards to teach you how to talk, so this is a bear.
No, it's okay, Doo-Doo Man, it's not really a bear, it's just a picture of a bear. Wait, have you even seen a bear?
Come over here, Doo-Doo Man. Say bear. Oh, that was perfect.
Ooh, nice.
That wasn't really a word.
Say dog. Ooh, that was good.
It was the same noise as bear.
Say yo-yo. Perfect.
Genius.
These aren't words.
Say apple. Oh, that was apple. That was perfect. Say juice. Oh, that was perfect.
Wait, apple juice. That's right. Guys, we need apple juice so we can send him back home.
Well, no, we need to teach him how to talk.
Well, we shouldn't be focused on teaching him how to talk. We should focus on sending him back where he came from.
How do we know where to send him back? Like, we need to get him to talk so he can tell us what year he's from, huh?
Yeah, I guess you're right. Okay, look, these cards aren't working. Go get your laptop so we can, like, get a translator app or something.
Oh, that's a good idea. Okay, guys, I got my laptop. Let's look up a translator. Oh, no! I forgot that entire video!
Junior, what the hell were you watching?
Nothing!
Dude, this is my favorite video!
It won't exit out!
Go to 922!
No!
Oh, the toes, though!
Oh, I think he wants you to put it back on.
No, Doo-Doo Man, we're not gonna watch that anymore. No, I'm not even supposed to be watching.
Okay, guys, how about we just get the apple juice? He's seen too much.
He hasn't seen enough! 922! 922! Go to it!
No, let's go get the apple juice. Doo-Doo Man, you stay right here. No!
No!
All right, Cody, grab the apple juice.
Okay. Wait, Junior, why is there a cat in your fridge?
There's not a cat in my fridge.
Yes, there is. There's a cat in your fridge.
I didn't know there was a cat. Just grab the apple juice.
Wait, okay.
Bye, kitty. You're not to be watching that.
Guys, we get the apple juice. Let's just send him home. But he keeps spitting on me.
Well, look, we can't send him home until we know what year he's from.
Well, it's not like he knows what year he's from. It's not like they had calendars back then.
You don't know that. He probably did have a calendar. He, like, chiseled it into a rock or something.
Well, then how are we going to talk to him?
I'll call a translator. How about that?
Okay. Hey there, you call the cops? Junior, why did you call the cops?
Because they translate things all the time. Like, when they arrest bad guys, they got to know what they're saying.
Yeah, I can speak all kinds of different languages. Hold on, let me talk to the little fella. Hey there, homie.
What?
What's crack-a-lackin'?
Not this again, dude. Come on.
Oh, hey. I'm not trying to harsh your buzz, brudda. What's all good in the hood?
Oh, no. Not him. We want you to talk to the caveman.
Why is he shouting at me? What, is this your grandpa or something?
No, it's a caveman.
What, is he, like, dressed like a caveman?
No, it's a real caveman from prehistoric times.
Well, he's eating my hat, so tell him to knock it off before I tase him.
Well, Doo-Doo Man, stop.
His name is Doo-Doo Man?
Play with that.
Okay, should I be worried about that?
No, he likes fire. So listen, can you translate what he's saying?
Translate? Listen, if that really is a caveman, I don't speak caveman. I think my ex-wife does, because I think she was with the caveman from the noises I heard coming out of our bedroom. He was like, ooh, ooh, ooga booga.
Oh, did we watch the same video? 922, right?
What? What's he talking about?
So can you help us or not?
No, listen, kids, I have real crimes to solve. Like, I'm pretty sure somebody out there is trying to use a counterfeit Applebee's gift card.
Come on, popcorn, pop already, God! Okay, I smell it burning, but it's not cooking! It's me! I'm the one who's cooking!
Jesus Christ! Oh my God!
Okay, I saw him set you on fire, I'm arresting that guy! Freeze, you're under arrest for arson and attempted murder! Hey, put the lighter down!
What? No. I don't care how much you try to suck me off to get out of going to jail. I've already let that happen too many times. Come on.
You're going to jail for a long time.
Wait, where are you going with Doo-Doo Man?
Well, Doo-Doo Man is more like Felony Man because he set your chef on fire.
Free my nigga Doo-Doo Man. He ain't do nothing wrong.
Well, he did do something wrong.
Nah, he just don't like him because he's brown, huh?
No. He's a white caveman and he's an arsonist. Look, get out of my way, kids.
All right, get in there. You have the right to remain silent. If you do not... You're a caveman. You don't know what I'm saying. You have the right.
Is there any way you can release Doo-Doo Man?
No, he's a dangerous animal. I can't let him free because he might end up hurting somebody else.
He just started your car.
Well, that's impossible. My car can't start because I'm not... Wait,
that caveman just stole my car! I thought you said he was a caveman! How does he know how to drive?
He is a caveman! What?
I stole the car! They're never gonna catch me!
But wait a minute. If he's me, that means I'm...
Dude, what the hell's going on?
I don't know, but Doo-Doo Man, get inside.
Ew, 922. Where's all the dudes? Well, hey, guys. What took so long? What happened?
I can't explain what just happened.
Me either, dude.
Okay, well, I put the apple juice in the portal gun, so we're ready to send him home.
And we still don't know what year to send him back to.
I don't think I really care. I just want him the hell out of here.
Okay, then make a portal gun.
Okay, he has to warm up first.
My clothes are all wet, and my hat's ruined! Oh, I hope I have another one in the closet.
Come on, warm up, you stupid gun.
How'd the dinosaur get out of the closet? I mean, I guess that kind of makes sense, because he's a dinosaur, and dinosaurs are strong, and that's just a little closet, and two doors probably wouldn't be able to hold him, and maybe Chef Pee-Pee went into the closet and tried to get a new hat, because his other hat got burned, but I wasn't there for that, so I don't know. Oh, hey, the gun's ready.
We'll make a port, hurry! Oh, Doo-Doo Man, you gotta go!
Don't take my laptop! Cody, he took my laptop with him!
Junior, we have bigger problems to deal with. We have this dinosaur right here!
What? Oh, Junior, look. I think he likes how shiny the portal gun is. Look, it's distracting him.
Well, then throw the portal gun in the portal and he'll chase after it.
Oh, but then we won't be able to do portals anymore.
Throw it inside the portal, Cody.
Okay. Thank God that's over with.
But Cody, how do we know that we sent them back to the right time?
I don't know, but we're still alive and we're still here, so it must not have affected much.
The news!
We discovered this MacBook Pro while digging for dinosaur fossils, which is very interesting because the Apple Corporation did not exist in 65 million BC. Now, we think this is proof that dinosaurs brought Apple products to Earth so that dinosaurs could use the internet. And apparently, dinosaurs liked very dirty websites because the search history of this laptop, it is just filthy.
Hey, that's my laptop! Guys, are you ready to play Nerf guns?
Oh yeah, dude, I'm so ready.
You guys should probably wear some eye protection.
Come on, Cody, you're ugly, but not that ugly.
Yeah, we're kind of used to you now, buddy.
No, I mean, so you don't shoot your eye out with a Nerf gun.
We're not gonna do that, Cody. We're not gonna aim for each other's eyes.
Yeah, we're not stupid.
Okay, well, I'm gonna keep my glasses on.
No, if we're not gonna wear glasses, you have to take yours off.
Well, why don't you just put glasses on?
Because it's two people that have to go find glasses and put them on when all you have to do is take yours off.
Well, I'm not taking my glasses off.
You're a stupid, dumb idiot.
Wimp.
I don't care what you call me, I'm not taking my glasses off.
No balls, take your glasses off.
Okay, well that's ridiculous. Obviously I have balls. I got two big hairy balls. Some would even say too hairy. Okay, there you go. I took my glasses off.
You are so ugly, Cody.
Dude, you look like a pufferfish.
You look like your name's Ted and you sit outside of school in a white van.
Did your mom drink while she was pregnant with you?
I'll have you know, my mom didn't even know she was pregnant for the first 5 months. So yeah, she drunk and partied a little bit. And then she stopped after she found out, after she celebrated a little more. But look, can we just play now?
Is your phone going off?
Yeah, my mom has a tracker on my glasses that tells her when I take them off.
But why?
I don't know, I just have to answer this. Okay, guys, I'm answering the phone. Now shut up, I don't want my mom to know we're playing with Nerf guns. Hey, Mom. Cody, why did you take your glasses off? I just took them off for a second to clean them. Cody, you've had your glasses off for several seconds. Wait, there's a timer on the tracker? Yes, Cody, now put your glasses back on. I will, Mom. And how are your hemorrhoids doing? Fine, Mom, just shut up.
Hey, Joseph, we should make moaning noises into the phone to make his mom think he's doing something weird.
Oh, yeah, dude, let's totally do it.
Oh, Cody, oh, yeah, oh.
Oh, no, Uncle, get out of my room. No, you can't come in here. Please, no, no, stop it. No, not my pants, please. Look, I don't care how many fun toys you get me. No, me, no.
Cody, what was that? I don't know, but it made me sad. Cody, put your glasses back on. Okay, Mom, damn! Look, guys, we gotta hurry up and play. My mom's gonna call me back.
Okay, let's play.
Ow! Jesus Christ!
You got him!
God damn, son of a bitch! Big hairy in my eye! Well, Junior, why did you do that?
Where did I shoot you at?
Right in the eye! Call a doctor!
Okay, I'll call a doctor. Can I use your phone?
Yes, fine, use the phone!
Why is it sticky?
I'm
using my phone.
Okay!
Hey there, somebody call a doctor? Jesus! Could you get that camera out of my face? Thank you. Did somebody call a doctor?
Yes, doctor. I accidentally shot my friend in the eye with a Nerf gun.
Jesus, what, did you shoot him in both eyes? But, buddy, how many times do I have to tell you to back up? Oh my God, amateurs. Did you shoot him in both eyes multiple times? Why are his eyes so swollen?
He always looks like that.
Oh, you poor bastard.
Am I gonna be okay?
Well, I think you're gonna have a hard time finding dates, but can you see?
Yeah?
I think you're gonna be just fine. But you kids really should have been using eye protection.
That's what I said, but then they said no balls.
Oh yeah, I've been there. I know how that goes. One time I was doing a surgery, and the nurse said, "No balls, you won't do the surgery blindfolded." So I did, and the guy died. But I mean, it was a tonsillectomy, so he's pretty much gonna die anyway, right? Like, a life without tonsils? What kind of life is that? I mean, don't talk to me if you don't have tonsils, right? Oh man, I bully people who don't have tonsils. Don't let me catch you without your tonsils. I'm gonna throw a party, and it's gonna be a tonsils-only party. And there's gonna be a bouncer outside. When you walk up, he's gonna say, "Say ah!" And if you don't have your tonsils, you're getting thrown out of the party. Tonsils rule!
Okay, guys, let's play for real this time, and do not shoot me in the eye again.
How can we not, dude? Your eyes cover majority of your face.
Well, just don't shoot me in the face.
That's too many rules. Let's play.
Oh, God, motherfucker, right in my f***ing eye. God, son of a...
Hey, guys, what are you doing?
Oh, we're playing with Nerf guns.
Oh, can I play?
Well, we only have three, so you should ask your dad to buy you a Nerf gun.
Okay, I will.
Oh, my eye. Ow. Ow.
Hey, Daddy. Ooh, Daddy.
Jeffy, stop talking to me like that.
Daddy, can you buy me some Nerf guns?
But no, Jeffy, I've bought you plenty of Nerf guns in the past.
Well, those are old and I lost all the bullets.
Well, I'm sorry, that's not my problem.
But Daddy, I need a new Nerf gun right now because all my friends are playing Nerf guns.
Okay, look, I don't have a reason to go to the store. I'm not going to the store just to buy you a Nerf gun.
Well, I think you need headache medicine.
Why? Ow, Jeffy, why would you do that?
Because I want Nerf guns!
Oh, okay, fine. Now I'm gonna go to the store and buy headache medicine and your dumb Nerf gun.
Thanks, Daddy.
All right, Jeffy, there's your dumb Nerf gun. Now leave me alone.
What the hell is that, Daddy?
It's the Nerf gun you wanted me to go to the store to get you.
That's not a Nerf gun. That's a Zuru X-Shot. What even is that?
It was cheaper, and they're all the same, Jeffy.
They're not the same, Daddy. I need to have the Nerf gun, the official Nerf gun.
No, Jeffy, look, this one's called a Zuru X-Shot. Doesn't that sound a lot cooler? Like, X-Shot.
I'm going to get made fun of for having this, Daddy.
No, look at the kid on the box. He looks like he's going to grow up and be a cool kid. And look, the bullets are black. And look, the gun, it has a skull on it. Ooh, that's pretty badass if you ask me. And your friends, they're going to say you're one cool bean.
One cool bean.
Yep, that's what they're going to call you. So look, go play with it.
All right, Daddy, they better say I'm one cool bean.
That's exactly what they're going to say. That's what all the kids are saying.
All right, guys, the bean is here.
The bean?
Yeah, I like flicking the bean and eating vagine.
All right.
Whoa, Jeffy, what kind of gun is that?
It's a Zuru X-Shot.
Wait, it's not a Nerf gun?
No, my daddy couldn't afford a Nerf gun because he hates me, so he bought me this piece of shit.
Oh, dude, it looks so cool and green. Can we trade?
Sure.
Ooh, yeah.
Be careful. She's loaded.
Oh, dude, this is awesome. I wonder how fast it shoots.
That sound brings back good memories.
But Jeffy, are you okay?
He shot that Nerf bullet down my throat!
Okay, guys, I don't think we should play Nerf guns anymore. It's too dangerous. Let's all just get into bed and cuddle. Actually, you still might get something shot in your eye.
But Jeffy, you should go tell your dad that you swallowed a Nerf bullet.
Okay, Junior. Daddy?
Wait, Jeffy, what do you want?
Don't get mad, but I was playing Nerf guns with my friends.
Spit it out!
And Joseph accidentally shot me in the mouth with a Nerf gun and I swallowed the bullet.
But you swallowed a Nerf bullet, Jeffy?
On accident!
Well, now we have to call a doctor.
Why? Do you think I'm gonna die?
Well, no, I just don't want the Nerf bullet to, like, turn sideways and clog your intestines and you get constipate to death or... I'm gonna call the doctor.
Hey there, somebody call a doctor?
Yes, doctor. So my son swallowed a Nerf...
Hold on. Back up. Back up! That's it.
Ow!
Come on.
Ow, jeez!
You need to get your shit together, man. You don't know what you're doing.
I'm just trying to do my job.
Well, do it better, okay? Pick up that camera. Pick it up. Okay. No, back up. You see? Right there. You don't get any closer than that.
Okay.
Jesus. Oh, I'm sorry, man. That guy's been pissing me off all day. So what do you need?
So my son, he swallowed a Nerf bullet.
Oh, that's fine. That happens.
Wait, so, like, you don't have to do surgery to get it out or anything?
Oh, no. He should poop it out in a couple days, as long as it was just a normal Nerf bullet.
Well, that's all it was.
No, Daddy, tell him what you did. Tell him how poor you are.
Okay, it wasn't a Nerf bullet. It was an off-brand, like, Zuru X-Shot bullet.
What? It was off-brand?
Yeah, it wasn't a Nerf bullet, but they're all the same thing, right?
No, this is very bad. Hold on. Okay, answer this very carefully. Did the Nerf bullet look like this, because this is a normal Nerf bullet, or did it look like this?
Can I see the other one again?
Okay, was it this, a normal Nerf bullet, or was it this?
It was that one.
Oh no, that's bad. That's very, very bad.
Why is this one bad?
Because it's black.
Why is it being black bad?
But is it not? Black is beautiful. It's my favorite color, actually. But no, this one's black because it has lead in it. See, it was made in a cheap Chinese factory where they make the off-brand Nerf bullets, so it has lead in it. So he's gonna get lead poisoning if he eats it.
He swallowed one!
That's not good. We need him to throw that up because if it hits his digestive system, the lead's gonna get into his bloodstream, then it's gonna get into his heart, then he's gonna have lead heart and he's gonna die.
Oh no! Jeffy, you have to throw up right now. You have to throw up or you're gonna die. Just please, Jeffy, just try to throw up for me. Just please, throw up.
I don't know how to throw up, Daddy.
Okay, just open your mouth and make noises like bleh, bleh,
bleh. Ah.
Oh, no, Jeffy, try harder. Try to throw up harder.
Ah.
Oh, he doesn't know how to throw up. Can you help him?
Okay, I have a trick that models use sometimes. Just stick your finger down your throat to try to make yourself throw up.
You want me to choke on your fingers, Daddy?
Okay, that's gross. I don't really want to do it now. Just
Oh, no, just tell him how to do it.
Just try to throw up. Throw up. Yeah, thin is beautiful, you little piggy. Yeah, that's it. Throw it up. Throw up all that nasty food and get thin.
Okay.
It's not working.
Yeah, it works when models do it. Okay, I have an idea. Hold on. Okay, this will definitely make Jeffy throw up.
It's just an empty jar.
Ah, it may look empty, but there's something in there.
What?
My fart. My big, loud, stinky fart.
Wait, what are you, five?
No, look, I grabbed an empty jar, I sat on it, I blew ass in there, and I slapped the lid on real quick before it could escape. Hey there, little fart. I got you, little rascal. You might fart.
There's no way this is gonna work.
It's gonna work. I did it all the time in college. Look, all Jeffy has to do is take the lid off and then sniff my fart really hard. It'll make him throw up.
All right, Jeffy, take the lid off and smell his fart.
All right.
Why are you drinking my fart?
It smells good.
Smells like beef and cheese.
Oh, okay. Now I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Okay, look, your stupid fart thing didn't work. Jimmy, let go of the fart. Stop drinking the fart.
Okay. I have another idea that'll definitely make him throw up.
Jimmy, stop the smelling of that.
Boom. Got him Burger King. That'll make him throw up.
Burger King?
Yep, it's disgusting. I mean, I used to love it as a kid, but now as an adult, I get food poisoning every time.
Well, I like Burger King, hence the crown.
My liege.
Wait, Jeffy, you like Burger King?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not gonna make him throw up.
Oh, man.
We gotta think of something. Come on, doctor, the lead poison's gonna kill him. We'll make him throw up.
Hold on, I just gotta dig in my ass and think for a second.
Wait, what? You're digging in your butt?
It helps me think. Oh, I have an idea. Jeffy, smell this.
Yummy! Here, you wanna smell mine?
No, I'm good. Does it really smell good? No, it's not good. Marvin, you wanna whip?
Everyone stop smelling their butts! Listen, we gotta find a way to make Jeffy throw up because if he dies of lead poisoning, it's gonna be my fault. Listen, because I bought him this stupid toy. Oh, we gotta think.
Well, I mean, you're his dad, so what usually makes him throw up?
Green beans! You hate green beans, right, Jeffy?
Yeah.
Okay, we gotta get green beans.
Well, do you have any green beans?
No, and we didn't think of the ending before we started filming, and it's midnight, so nothing's open. We can't buy any green beans right now.
Well, I mean, I have this. I don't know if it helps.
Wait, a printed out picture of green beans? You just have this?
Yeah, I just keep it on me in case of emergencies.
Jeffy, look at the picture.
I hate green beans, Daddy!
I think it's working. I think he's gonna throw up. Hey, he threw it up.
Yeah, he threw it up.
No lead poisoning tonight. We on a diet.
All right, Jeffy, shut up. All right, so we threw it up. All right, Jeffy, so you learned not to eat Nerf bullets, right?
Yeah, but you gotta stop buying all the poor brand.
Yeah, I mean, he can eat Nerf bullets, just not those. Hey, don't really eat Nerf bullets. Back it up. I'm trying to tell them, don't eat Nerf bullets.
Yeah, don't eat them. This is just a joke. But anyway, Jeffy, okay, fine. I won't buy you the off-brand anymore. I'll actually buy you Nerf brand from now on.
Good.
Hey, guys, do you guys have your tonsils?
I have mine.
Well, I got mine removed when I was 13.
Loser! Tonsil-less loser! What a loser! Alright, I'm gonna take off.
Hello?
Is Cody here?
Cody, your mom's here!
Hey, Mom. Cody, why are your glasses off? Oh no, I forgot to put them back on. Cody, that's it! Your little tushy's grounded! Come on, you little bug-eyed freak, we're going home!
Jeffy, grab a tissue. That's disgusting.
I'll try biting it.
Well, don't bite it, Jeffy. That's gross. Don't lick it. Jeffy, look, we have to grab a tissue or something.
No, Daddy, I need you to pull it. Hurry.
This is so gross. Ew. Hey, oh.
Thanks, Daddy.
Jeffy, that is disgusting. Look, you're annoying me today. What happened to your pencil?
Oh, I put it right here, Daddy, so I could sneeze.
Wait, it doesn't hurt your brain?
What brain?
That's right, you don't have a brain. Look, Jeffy, you're annoying me. I just want to have a relaxing day inside. So go outside and do something fun.
Oh, like go around your neighborhood and take pictures of the cat's buttholes and make a collage and put it on your refrigerator?
No, that's disgusting, Jeffy, don't.
CBC, cat butt collage!
No, Jeffy, how about you go fishing in the lake?
Fishing?
Yeah, look at this. Here's a fishing pole, Jeffy. It's a Spider-Man pole.
Daddy, why got Spider-Man's pole? You like it when he shoots his web? You think that's hot?
Jeffy, shut up. Just go outside and try to catch something in the lake. If you catch something, I'll give you a prize.
Really, Daddy? What's the prize?
I don't know. You have to catch something in the lake first to find out.
Okay, Daddy.
He's never going to catch anything in that lake. There's no fish in it.
All right, little fishers, prepare to suck my pole. Yeah. Oh, man, I guess the fishies aren't biting today. Oh, what? What is that? Pow, I think I got some. I'm going to rear you in, you big bastard. Yeah. What is that? Daddy, I caught something. Daddy, I caught something.
Jeffy, what did you just do to me?
I wanted to show you what I caught, Daddy.
Jeffy, that's a jellyfish. There's no way you caught a jellyfish in the lake.
Well, I did, Daddy. I'm like SpongeBob out here.
Oh, my God, my face is so much pain. Call a doctor, Jeffy. Call a doctor.
Hey, Leah, somebody call a doctor.
Oh, my God. My son put a jellyfish in my face and it stung me.
That sucks. Yeah, I got stung by a jellyfish one time.
I'm in so much pain. Please help.
Hey. If I'm gonna listen to your story, you have to listen to mine. So I got stung by a jellyfish last summer. Yeah, I remember it just like it was this summer, but it was last summer. I was at the beach with my wife Karen. She was sunbathing, and all the lifeguards thought she was a beached whale, so they wanted to blow her up, because that's what they do to beached whales. And I was like, no, that's not a beached whale, that's just my wife. And I was making the sandcastle, and oh, it was the coolest sandcastle ever, you should have seen it. And then out of nowhere, this huge wave comes and just wipes out my sandcastle. So I'm like, bitch-ass ocean? So I run into the water and I start throwing haymakers, trying to teach that ocean a lesson. But then the problem is, I can't really swim too good, and I get caught in a rip current, so I get sucked out to sea. And the lifeguard sees me, but he can't swim either. I mean, what a terrible lifeguard. What kind of lifeguard can't swim? So I'm just out there drowning, and I think I'm gonna die. So I'm looking for any way I can to save myself. And then I see this jellyfish. So I'm thinking, oh, I can just grab onto this jellyfish and ride him to shore. So I grab onto the jellyfish's tentacles, and he starts stinging the shit out of my hands. So I'm like, bitch-ass jellyfish, and I start throwing haymakers. And every time I hit the jellyfish, he's just stinging me more and more. And I'm in so much pain, I'm getting stung by a jellyfish, and I'm still drowning. I'm like 5 feet underwater by this point. And then I see a scuba diver, and he sees me, and he puts his oxygen mask on me so I can breathe, and he takes me back to shore, and I thank him. And as I'm walking up the beach, I step on a seashell, and I'm like, bitch-ass seashell. So I start throwing haymakers. And then every time I hit the sand, it's just hurting my hands more and more, and I'm realizing it's because that jellyfish stung me. So then I go back into the ocean to find that bitch-ass jellyfish. And then I go out there, and the jellyfish pulls up in a box Chevy with all his buddies, and they start kicking my ass, and they're stinging me all over the place, and one of them gave me a wet willy sting right in the ear. That hurt like hell. So then I get stung up, and it's just a whole big problem. And then finally I'm done at the beach, and my wife won't even take me to McDonald's afterwards. So yeah, that's why I don't go to the beach anymore.
Can you please help me? I'm in so much pain.
Were you even listening to my story?
Yeah, I was. Whatever. Look, I need a lot of help. My face hurts.
Do I have to tell you another jellyfish story? Because I have one.
Oh, no, please don't tell me more stories.
No, don't worry. It'll be quick. So me and my wife were scuba diving off the coast of Australia, right? And then we come up on this big, dark, scary trench, and my wife wants to go through the trench, but I want to go over the trench because it's a scary trench. I'm saying there has to be monsters in there. So we decide to go over the trench, and we see this cute little jellyfish, and my wife names it Squishy, and she starts touching it, and I'm like, don't touch it, it's a jellyfish. And then, next thing we know, there's all these jellyfish all around us, and then we're like surrounded by jellyfish. We're in like a goddamn forest of jellyfish, and I'm like, oh no, what are we gonna do? We're gonna get stung to death by all these jellyfish. But then we realize we can get through the jellyfish by bouncing on top of them. So then we start having like a jellyfish race to see who can get through the jellyfish forest the fastest, and I win, obviously. And then I look back and I see my wife, and she's all tangled up in jellyfish tentacles getting stung. So I'm like, oh god, I gotta go back and get her. So I go back and I'm getting stung by all the jellyfish, and I get stung so much I black out. And when I wake up, I'm on the back of a sea turtle, and he calls me Jelly Man because I took on the jellies. And he's like, you were like, whoa, and I was like, whoa, and I was like, oh, wait, this is Finding Nemo. This didn't happen to me. This happened in Finding Nemo. Damn it, I gotta stop doing
this. Listen, I'm in a lot of pain. I don't have time for you to waste any more time. My face hurts. I got stung by this jellyfish. Can you please help me?
Okay, hold on. Let me get my phone so I can Google what kind of jellyfish this is. All right, let's look at this jellyfish.
Yeah, what kind of jellyfish is it?
Oh, my God, no. No, no, no. Oh, God, please, no.
What?
My wife is cooking pot roast for dinner. Oh, God, that's so gross. It's all chewy and disgusting.
What kind of jellyfish is this?
You know, one time my wife cooked pot roast, and I spent all day just chewing it. Like, why you gotta be so chewy, you bitch-ass pot roast? So I started throwing haymakers.
Can you please find out what kind of jellyfish this is? My face in so much pain.
Oh, right, yeah, I guess I'll just Google, balls in jellyfish. Oh, God, ew, don't Google that. Oh, why would you even do that? Look at that.
Ew, what's he doing to that jellyfish?
Oh, I don't know.
Can we please find out what kind of jellyfish this is? You're wasting so much time.
Yeah, you know what? I actually know somebody who knows a lot about jellyfish. I'll just call my buddy Sponge Robert Squareshirt. All right, it's right here.
Hello?
Hey, Robert, it's me, Brooklyn Guy.
Oh, hey, Brooklyn Guy.
Well, nothing's funny, but listen, I got this jellyfish here, and I need you to tell me what kind it is.
Oh, I love jellyfish. Me and Patrick go all the time.
I didn't ask that, but look, it's a blue jellyfish that has balls in it.
Have you ever tried jellyfish jelly on a Krabby Patty? It's so yummy.
That does sound pretty yummy, but can we please stay on track? It's a blue jellyfish.
Wait, did you say a blue jellyfish? That's no name. Mr. Krabs is gonna put it in a factory if you don't give him back.
Okay, you have been no help at all. I'm sorry about that, ma'am.
Listen, you're a doctor, for God's sake. Find out what kind of jellyfish it is. What if I die?
Oh, you know what? I bet we can take a picture of it and then post that picture on some kind of jellyfish form, and maybe somebody will recognize it. Oh, look, somebody knows what it is.
What is it? What is it?
It looks like it's the rare freshwater Westheimer blue tang accordion box jellyfish.
Is it dangerous?
It says here it's the most venomous jellyfish in the world.
Venomous? Am I gonna die?
5 minutes after you get stung, it can cause brain hemorrhaging, and then your organs are gonna shut down.
No. Okay, is there any way to stop it? Is there a way to stop it?
It says the only way to stop it is you have to pee on the wound.
Pee on the wound? No one is gonna pee on my face.
I'll do it, Daddy.
No, I'm not gonna let anyone pee on my face.
I guess you're gonna die then.
What? I mean, okay, fine. If anyone's gonna do it, I want you to do it. You're a doctor.
Me? Oh, I would be honored. You hear that, Mrs. Stevenson, my third grade teacher? I am somebody now. I'm gonna pee on a man's face.
Well, let's just hurry up and get this over with. Just do it.
Okay, what do you want to do it? I'm excited now.
We're not gonna do it on the couch.
Oh, yeah, this is too nice of a couch to save your life on.
Yeah, we can just do it in the bathroom.
All right, lead the way, piss face.
Well, I'm not that yet.
Soon to be piss face?
Is your pee at least clean?
I mean, I gotta warn you, I drink a lot of sodas and eat a lot of asparagus, so my pee's gonna be stinky.
I don't want to know that. You shouldn't have told me that. Let's just get this over with.
Okay, so we're in the bathroom.
Okay, I guess let's do it.
Yeah, just start. Just do it. Just get over with.
Can I shave first?
Shave? Why do you gotta shave?
Well, I haven't shaved in a while. I feel kind of gross still.
I don't care. I'm not gonna be looking at it. Just pee on my face.
Okay, but I'm a gorilla, not a goa, so can I get it started a little?
No, I'm not gonna be looking at that. Just hurry up and save my life.
Can you at least close your eyes? I don't want you looking at it.
I would close my eyes, but my eyes hurt too bad to close them.
Alright,
how about this? How about you start peeing on the back of my head, and then I'll turn around really quick and go on my face.
You want me to pee on your back and your face? I'm gonna start charging at this point.
How about this? Okay, look, I'll be down here by the bathtub. You start peeing, and then you just turn real quick and aim it at my face.
I don't know. I think I'm gonna get pee all over your bathroom.
I don't care. Just do it. Or how about this? I'll start in the toilet.
I don't like that I know you're in there. Okay, how about this? How about I leave the bathroom, then you get in the toilet, and then I come in and pretend I'm just peeing like normal, and then I'll pee right on your face, but I won't look at you. I'll just stare at you, okay?
Okay, I like that. Okay, leave.
Okay, I'll do it. Oh, man, I sure do have to pee. Okay, here I go. Oh, God, no, this isn't gonna work. I definitely can't do it now. You look like some kind of piss goblin.
Well, you just aren't supposed to do it. You weren't even supposed to look.
Yeah, I know, but I had to lift the seat, and you were just there. It was creepy.
Okay, how are we gonna do this? How about you just pee in a cup and throw it on my face?
No, I think it has to be fresh out of my body.
Does it say that on the website?
I don't know. Maybe. I think so.
Okay, we gotta find a way to do this. But what if I just lay on my back and just pee on myself?
I don't think so. I think it has to be somebody else's pee.
Why?
I don't know. It just makes sense to me.
Oh, okay, listen, oh, man.
You want to just do it in the shower?
Yeah, let's get in the shower. Okay. And then once we're in the shower, we'll feel better.
Yeah.
Okay, we're in the shower. Let's do this.
Okay, let's do it.
Well, why do you have your clothes off?
Well, I'm not going to have my clothes on in the shower.
You're not getting wet.
Well, this way it feels more normal, like I'm just peeing in the shower.
Okay, then just hurry up and do it.
Well, maybe you should take your clothes off, too.
What? No, I don't need to take my clothes off.
Well, you're going to get pee all over.
I don't care. I'm trying to save my life. Just hurry up and do it.
Hey.
Why are you doing it?
I don't have to go right now.
You don't have to go. You said you drink a lot of sodas.
I do, but for some reason I can't go.
Okay, what can I do to make you more comfortable? We have to do this.
Maybe if you pee your pants, that'll help.
But why would me pee my pants help you pee?
Because we're both peeing, then it's not weird.
What are you, five? We both need to pee at the same time?
Look, it'll help me pee. Just do it.
Okay, I'll pee my pants. Just go.
Okay, on three, we'll both pee. 3, 2, 1.
Thank you for saving my life.
Sure thing. Anytime, man. You know, I actually kind of like it. I think I'm really into it.
Jeffy, you're going to get rid of this jellyfish because I don't want it stinging me because I don't want to get peed on again.
I wanted to keep him, Daddy.
You're not keeping this jellyfish. Throw it back in the lake. Look, I don't care what you do with it. Just get rid of it. Just put it somewhere. I don't care.
Go back to the bathroom. You know, this actually kind of reminds me of this one time when the SML question popped up. And... Say something new.
Well, fellas, what kind of activities would you like to partake in this evening?
I like that better.
Ooh,
What a classy gentleman you, but I'm bored.
Yeah, me too. God, check it out. I got my daddy's credit card.
You stole your dad's credit card?
It's only stealing if you get caught.
Bingo.
Well, you're still using it without his permission, so that is stealing.
No, this is my daddy's credit card, and if he were to die, then I would inherit.
That's not how credit cards work.
Shut up, Cody. What are you gonna buy, Jeffy?
Oh, no. What do you guys think I should buy?
Something involving balls. I like balls.
Ski ball machine.
I heard skeet and balls, so I need
a ski ball machine. I've always wanted one, Joseph.
Me too.
Oh, Jeffy, go buy a ski ball machine.
All right, guys, we got a ski ball machine. All thanks to my daddy's credit card.
Woo! I love committing a felony.
Dreams do come true. Back on Friday.
Oh. Cody, what are you doing?
I'm trying to put the ball in my mouth.
Roll the ball, Cody.
Come on, dude.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, get 100.
Oh my God, you really got this game, Cody. You're not supposed to throw it, Jeffy. Well, you got to throw it. No, you're not supposed to throw it. You're going to break it if you throw it like that. Oh, you guys broke the game.
You need to have a turn yet.
Why is my daddy's credit card? If anyone can break this game ball machine, it's me.
Yeah, I mean, I guess he's right.
Well, now what game are we going to play? We never got a turn.
I think it should be a game involving balls and men.
Oh, I got the perfect idea.
Strong dudes fight over a ball, wish it was me.
I don't like this game. It's pretty segregated. Blacks versus whites.
Well, we all know who's gonna win. You guys are much faster and stronger than us.
But you guys drive pickup trucks and lock your keys in hot corn.
You get to that 45 minutes.
Oh, look at you, nigga. How many of peach, though? You know what? Better yet, name a good white rapper.
Eminem.
Honest, I get me. Come on.
Name a black NASCAR driver.
Nobody wants his NASCAR.
Who wants to punch me in football?
You gotta hit the ball in the middle. Cody! Guys, look, I don't like this game. Cody, stop it. All right, guys. Jeffy, why don't you buy a ball pit?
Oh, sure, woman.
No, like, a pit full of balls, like a Chuck E. Cheese, we gonna dive in.
Oh, okay. I'll buy one of those. All
right.
Best purchase ever.
All right, guys, keep the ball pit.
Whoa! This is the biggest ball that I've ever seen. How deep is it?
Like 10 feet.
Jeffy, you jump in first.
All right. Sayonara, hoes.
Oh, I want to jump in.
Let me jump in.
Sup?
Where are we?
It looks like some kind of pocket of air inside the ball pit.
Oh, it's like a cool little hideout.
But can we get out if we wanted to?
Oh, let me see. What guys, the balls, they won't open up.
I've never been this balls deep before.
Well, Cody, I mean, you would enjoy having all these balls around you, right?
Well, yeah, but not these kind of balls.
Well, guys, if we want to get out, we can't. What are we going to eat?
I don't know, dude.
Let's scream out.
Help!
Help!
Jeffy, have you seen my credit card? Jeffy, it's missing out of my wallet. You better not have taken it and bought something, Jeffy.
What is this? A ski ball machine?
In a foosball machine? Jeffy, that is it. You are so grounded.
What? Is that my phone? Hello?
Hey, Marvin.
Goodman, why are you calling me?
Did you win the lottery recently?
No.
Did your grandfather die and you inherit a bunch of money?
No.
So then why are you running up your credit card like you do have a bunch of money?
Well, I haven't ran up my credit card. I haven't used it once.
Okay. Well, let's go with your purchases, shall we? $3,000 skee-ball machine?
$3,000?
$2,000 foosball table?
$2,000?
$5,000 ball pit?
$5,000 ball pit?
You're making a lot of ball-related purchases, Marvin. So if you don't pay off your credit card by the end of the month, I'm gonna show up to your house, and I'm gonna bite your balls off, then I'm gonna put a tutu on and swing your balls around like a ballerina.
Well, listen, someone stole my credit card, Goodman, but here's the thing, they left all the expensive things at my house, so I can just return it.
Okay, well, let's hope they left the receipt at your house, too.
Well, I'm gonna find the receipt, and I'm gonna return all this stuff so I don't owe anything on my credit card.
Well, for your balls, let's hope.
Oh, you don't have to worry about that.
Jimmy! Where's the receipt for all this stuff, Jimmy? Where are you at, Jimmy? I need that receipt, Jimmy!
But
are you in the ball pit? Are you in here, Jimmy?
There's no point in screaming for help. No one's gonna hear us down here.
I know you're in here, Jimmy. Wait, that's my daddy!
Well, scream help so he can hear us.
No! Because he's gonna be really mad that I took his credit card.
Well, I mean, yeah, I'd be mad if somebody stole my credit card, too.
Well, we gotta be safe. Help!
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 Guess he's not in there. Aha! I found your shoe, Jeffy! I know you're in there!
You're just choosing not to come out. Well, guess what? I'm gonna call the cops, and I'm gonna say that you stole my credit card because you're 18, and that's credit card fraud, and you're gonna go to jail, Jeffy. You don't care? Okay, I'm gonna call the cops.
I can't believe your dad didn't hear screaming for help.
Well, at least I'm not grounded.
Well, we still have to get out of here.
Man, if we had a girl in here, we could totally repopulate.
I mean, just close your eyes and pretend I'm a girl.
Hey there, you call the cops?
Yeah.
The one?
Oh, you want me to start talking?
No, I thought we'd all just sit here and guess why you called us. Or maybe we can play I Spy. Hey, Simmons, I spy with my little eye a massive waste of police resources.
It's him, Simmons.
Oh, that's the little bugger.
Where are you from?
All right, look, this is what happened. Someone stole my credit card and bought a skee ball machine and a foosball table and a ball pit. And I know who did it, but I don't want to tell you.
Okay, so it seems to me like all the stuff you just listed is here.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, so somebody stole your credit card, had all the stuff shipped to you, and you set it up like you were going to use it?
Yeah, well, see, like when the boxes came, I set it all up, and then I realized I didn't buy this.
So you put all the balls into the ball pit before you realized you didn't buy them?
Oh, okay, look, can I just tell you the truth?
Yes, I would prefer that. I don't know why we didn't just start with that.
Okay, so look, my son went to my wallet, took my credit card, bought all this stuff, and now he's hiding in the ball pit and won't come out.
Okay, so you called us to, what, spank him?
Well, no, he's 18, so like, I want you to, like, arrest him.
Oh, you want to press charges?
Only if he doesn't have the receipt to return all this stuff.
So let me see if I have this straight. Your son stole your credit card, bought all this stuff, and now you want us to arrest him if he doesn't have the receipts to return the stuff?
Exactly.
You writing all this down, Simmons?
I don't have a pen.
Thank you, Simmons.
Yeah, so, like, that's what I want you to do.
Okay, so let me see if I have this right. You want two professional police officers to dive into a ball pit during work hours?
Yes.
Ooh, I love my job so much sometimes!
Okay, but before we do that, all this talk about credit card fraud is reminding me of when I had my credit card stolen.
You had your credit card stolen?
I did, Simmons. Thank you for asking. And I want to tell you all about it. All right, Simmons, just like we practiced. Da-da-da-da-da-da. I once had my credit card stolen. I tried to get it back. Actually, you know what, Simmons? Let's not sing it. That's kind of lame. I'll just tell you about it instead. So I'm at my doctor job at the hospital, right? And I'm doing this long 18-hour open heart surgery. And it's taking 4 hours. I'm getting tired. I'm getting hungry. So eventually, I tell the patient and the nurses, hey, I'm gonna go get lunch real quick. I'll be right back. So I go out into the waiting room where we have the vending machines. We have one of those nice vending machines, the new ones that takes credit cards, so it doesn't even matter if you don't have cash. So then I see they have Cheez-Its in the vending machine. And you know I'm gonna get Cheez-Its because I love Cheez-Its. So I swipe my card, get a bag of Cheez-Its. I swipe my card again, I get a second bag of Cheez-Its. And I'm thinking, two bags of Cheez-Its are not enough Cheez-Its. I gotta buy the whole damn row of Cheez-Its. So I swipe my card again, and as I'm doing that, I notice, out of the corner of my eye, I see somebody with binoculars watching me buy Cheez-Its. And I'm thinking, why would somebody have binoculars in a hospital watching me buy Cheez-Its? And then I realize, he must be with the Cheez-It Corporation. He's trying to keep track of how many Cheez-Its a single person can buy. And I'm thinking, maybe I'm gonna win some kind of contest, you know, because I'm buying all these Cheez-Its. So I start swiping my card really slow so he can get all my information, because I want to make sure he can track me down to give me all my Cheez-It reward, you know? So then I buy like 7 bags of Cheez-Its, and then I walk over to the guy, because my curiosity is getting the best of me. I'm like, hey, I see you. And then the guy hides his binoculars. And then I'm like, no, I already caught you. I know you're with the Cheez-It Corporation. And then he's like, no, sir, I'm not with the Cheez-It Corporation. And I'm like, no, I saw your binoculars. I already got you. And then I see in front of him, he has a piece of paper with a bunch of numbers on it. And it looks kind of like a credit card number. Then I realize that must be all the Cheez-Its I've bought in my lifetime. I'm definitely winning this contest. So I give the guy my name and my home address and my social security number, all the information he needs, you know, because I also want to make sure that I can write this off as a gift on my taxes when I get all my Cheez-Its. So he's so happy. Like, he's so happy to have all this information. So I'm like, I definitely won this contest. So I go back home to my wife and I'm like, honey, Cheesy Wonka is gonna give me the Cheez-It factory. I'm gonna be a Cheez-It king. She doesn't believe me. She thinks I'm crazy. And I'm like, honey, you just watch. This is gonna be awesome. So I sit back and I'm feeling good. I'm feeling confident. And then my phone starts ringing. And it's my credit card company. And they said that my credit cards are all maxed out. And then my bank calls and said they're repossessing my house and my credit is ruined. Because it turns out there was no Cheesy Wonka. And that guy did not work for the Cheez-It company. He was a credit card scammer. And he stole my identity and all of my money. So now, whenever I see somebody with binoculars, I just start throwing haymakers. Like, One time, I was in the park, and I saw these old ladies with binoculars, and then I started throwing haymakers. And yeah, it turns out they were bird watching, but still. So yeah, just be glad it was your son that stole your credit card, and not some binoculars-wielding scammer from the made-up Cheez-It factory.
Okay, can we get Jeffy out of the ball pit to see if we can find the receipts?
Yeah, sure.
Ball pit time, Simmons!
Wow, this ball pit looks pretty deep.
I was balls deep in your mother last night.
Thank you, Simmons. Now I have that image in my head.
Can you just go in the ball pit and grab Jeffy?
I don't know, man. This looks kind of deep. I don't want to drown.
What, drowned in plastic balls?
Do you know how many ball pit-related deaths there are every year?
No.
Well, neither do I, but it's got to be at least one, and I don't want to be it.
So you're telling me that Jeffy could be dead in there?
I don't know, man.
Well, just go in there. You're a cop.
Okay, but if I yell help, you help, okay, Simmons?
I got it.
I mean, that should go without saying, but with you, I don't really know. Okay. Oh, God. Oh, God, I'm sinking. Simmons, help me!
I got your leg!
Simmons, you saved my life!
I don't know what I would do without you.
Never let go, Simmons.
I won't.
Can you guys go in there and grab my son?
Hey, I almost died, man.
Oh, okay, look, so none of you are gonna go in there.
Hey, I have an idea. How about you go in here?
Okay, I got an idea. How about we wrap like a string around one of you guys so if you go down there, we can pull you out?
Ooh, that's a pretty good idea.
Okay, I'm gonna go grab a string.
Okay.
There you go.
What am I gonna do?
You're a better swimmer than me, Simmons. Back at the academy, we used to call you Swimmins.
Oh, that's right. I did get a bronze medal for swimming.
Yeah, so when you get in there, when you find Jeffy, you tug 3 times, we'll pull you out.
Alright, what happens if I tug 4 times?
That means you need to pee.
What about 5 times?
That means you have to poop.
What about 6 times?
That means you want some Cheez-Its.
What about 7 times?
Well, that means you want to go to Outback Steakhouse when we're done here.
Alright, well, let's go tug it. Let's get some of that shrimp on the barbie.
Oh, yeah, the chocolate thunder from down under.
No, you're not gonna tug more than 3 times. You only tug 3 times. If you find someone on an emergency habit, you tug 3 times.
Well,
go.
Wait, how many times was this supposed to tug?
3.
We're never gonna be saved. I'm so hungry.
Yeah, we might need to eat someone, dude.
Start with my butt.
Jesus Christ.
A police officer, we're saved!
Order ass. Before you accuse me of anything, I didn't do it.
Well, there's 4 of you.
Well, yeah. You're here to save us?
Yeah, let's go, kids. What you're gonna do is you're gonna hold on to each other's hands, and we're gonna pull you out of here.
Okay.
Come on, dude.
All right.
What, how many was that? Was that Cheez-Its or Outback?
Just pull, pull, pull.
We're free!
I was a free man, massa.
Simmons, you saved 4 boys. You're a hero.
I'll draw, mate.
Well, Jeffy, do you have all the receipts for all the stuff you just bought?
No.
Well, come on, Jeffy. So, Jeffy, you do not have any of the receipts for all the expensive stuff you bought on my credit card?
Well, I do have the receipts, but kind of not.
Well, how you kind of not? You either don't have it or you do.
Well, I do have the receipt.
Then show it to me.
But I spit my gum into it. This is deserved. I am a shithead.
So, are we pressing charges? Am I going Outback? What are we doing?
Oh my class, today's gonna be a wrong boring day. We're gonna be learning about numerical analysis. So we're gonna spend all day breaking down this really long equation until you guys understand it. So step one, right here.
Teacher, can me and Heidi leave class to go to cheer practice? We have a competition coming up.
Yes, but that would be if you can go. But the rest of the class, you gotta stay here and do this boring shit.
Come on, Heidi.
Hey! They gonna leave class and go do cheerleading? Cheerleading's not even a sport. All they do is just shake pom-poms. Hey, guys, you wanna lie and say we have to go to cheer practice, too?
Yeah, dude, let's do it!
No, guys, I want to stay here and learn about numerical analysis. I put the anal in analysis.
Come on, Cody, you have to go with us. Teacher, can me, Joseph, and Cody go to cheer practice, too?
Are you 3 really a part of the cheer team?
Yeah, we're part of the cheer team. Guys, follow my lead. Give me an F!
F!
Give me an A!
A!
Give me a T!
T!
What's Cody's mom?
Fat!
Fat! Fat! Fat! Fat! Fat! Fat!
Woo!
You get it, Cody? She's fat?
Oh, that's pretty good. You must be part of the cheer team. You can go.
Guys, it worked. Okay, let's go to cheer practice.
No, dude, I'm going home. I'm not cheering like the damn girl.
Come on, Cody. Let's go make fun of the girls at cheer practice.
Come on, Heidi. Let's practice our cheer routine.
Oh, no, they're having seizures. Cody, call the nurse.
What are you doing here, Junior? Go back to class.
We want to see what cheer practice looked like.
Mind your own business. Go away.
But me and Cody want to join the cheer team.
You can, Junior. You're boys.
Ooh, Cody. Some somebody doesn't know what year it is. It's 2022, Penelope. Boys can join girl sports.
Just go away, Junior.
I want to join the team so you can stand on my shoulders and I can look up.
No, Junior. It's duos. It's two girls.
One cup. Remember that, Cody? Where they pooped in the cup? Is it real? Well, anyway, speaking of two girls, how about a little girl-on-girl action, right, Cody?
Ew, Junior, go away!
Well, come on, Penelope! Okay, how about me and Cody, we start our own cheer team, and we go out against your team?
Ha, I'd like to see you try. Come on, show me one cheer.
All right, Cody, like we did in the classroom. Give me an F!
No.
Why not?
I'm not gonna fall for that again, Junior.
Wow, you guys are really good. I'm scared now.
Well, we have to work on our team chemistry. Look, we're gonna go home and practice, and then we're gonna cheer circles on you bitches.
Okay.
All right, Cody, are you ready for this cheer competition?
Junior, I really like these outfits you got us, and as long as you don't wear underwear and stand on my shoulders, I'm down for whatever.
I think we're gonna win, right, Cody?
No, I think we're absolutely gonna get destroyed. But hey, I'm along for the ride.
Cody, it can't be that hard to cheer. All they did was this.
Well, yeah, I guess that is basically what they were doing.
Yeah, so we're naturals at it. We're gonna win. We don't even have to practice.
Well, I think we should still practice.
No. We shouldn't practice. We should spend all our time and energy trying to get them disqualified, because if we have no competition, we're gonna win.
Well, I guess that's true, but how would we get them disqualified?
By this. Steroids.
Where the hell did you get steroids?
There was some creepy clown that gave it to me. But look, if we give these steroids to the girls, then they'll get disqualified because we'll tell the cheerleading committee that we think they're on roids and they'll get tested and then they will be banned and then we will win.
But Junior, how are we even going to give them the steroids?
You leave that up to me.
No, Heidi. It's twist, twist, jump, hair, toss, twist.
I'm sorry.
We're going to lose.
Hey, ladies.
Junior, what are you wearing?
Oh, these are just our cheer outfits.
Jealous much?
Yeah, Cody, your hair does look pretty cool.
Oh, thank you.
Junior, why are you holding a needle?
Oh, well, the flu's going around, so I just want to make sure you girls got your flu shot.
Yeah, I did.
Well, what strand was it? Was it flu A?
I think so.
Well, this one's flu B, and flu B's going on really bad, so you should get this shot.
No, thank you.
I don't want my flu shot.
Oh, then you need this.
Ow. Junior, what the hell is wrong with you?
Look, I just protected her from the flu by giving her the flu, so take that.
That's not how it works.
Okay, come on, Cody, let's get out of here.
All right, well, I got your anonymous tip about that girl using steroids, so I tested her.
And she's disqualified?
No, we didn't find any steroids in her system, but she did test positive for HIV. Very sad.
Junior, where the hell did you get that needle?
Billy, you told me that was a steroids needle.
I thought.
Well, great, Junior. Now we ruined a girl's life because of an elementary school cheer competition.
We gotta think of another way to get them disqualified.
Junior, I think we should just give up on getting them disqualified.
Well, do you think that girl, now that she has HIV, do you think she's gonna feel good enough to cheer?
Yeah, probably.
Well, we have to find a way to make the girl so sick that they back out of the cheering competition.
Well, how are we gonna do that, Junior?
By putting laxatives in their drink, and then they start pooping everywhere, and they're like, I can't cheer in front of everyone if I'm gonna poop everywhere.
Junior, I don't think they're gonna trust any drink we give them after we gave that girl HIV.
Listen, I'll get them to drink the drink. Here, go get me a glass I can pour Miralax in. Hey, ladies.
Not now, Junior. Heidi randomly got blood tested and found out some really sad news.
It's okay.
Well, you know what would make you girls feel better? Some ginger ale.
No, Junior.
Oh, come on. It's ginger ale.
Oh, that's yum.
No, Heidi.
Oh, that's right. Drink up that ginger ale. How's it making you feel?
I gotta go to the bathroom.
See, Cody, I told you.
Told him what?
Just that you guys would want some ginger ale?
Yeah, me and Cody had a bet going on. I bet him $10 that bitches love ginger ale.
What did you do to the ginger ale, Junior?
I put laxatives in it. So when you girls drink it up, you'd be pooping all night and you wouldn't be able to dance in the competition tonight.
The competition's tomorrow, Junior.
Oh, great, Junior. Not only do we give her HIV, now she's going to be in the toilet all night.
What?
Let's go. Junior, I think I'm dropping out of our cheer team.
Why?
Because we've done so much harm to this innocent girl, and I feel really bad.
Don't feel bad, Cody. Let's win for her. We'll win in her honor.
Wait, shouldn't we let her win?
No! She's on a cheer team for a reason. She loves competition. If we just drop out and let her win, she'll feel bad.
Well, I think she's gonna feel bad now that she has HIV and diarrhea.
Come on, Cody, listen. If I promise no more guerrilla warfare, will you stay on the team?
Yeah, I guess that's what I'd call that.
Okay, I promise no more physical harm to the other team.
What kind of harm are we gonna do?
We're gonna do other kinds of harm, because I got other ways to get them disqualified.
Ugh, Junior, come on.
No, listen, it's not gonna harm them physically. No more pain, okay? So this is what we're gonna do. There's gonna be judges at this competition, right? And judges will not vote for racists.
Yeah.
So if we can get on video Penelope and her friend to say the N-word, then the judges will not vote for some racist, and then we will have the advantage.
Junior, why would they ever say that?
Just leave that up to me.
No, no, because every time you say that, something terrible happens.
I'm gonna get him to say it. Just follow my lead. Okay, Cody, are you recording?
Yeah.
Hey, ladies.
Go away, Junior!
I'm just here to apologize.
Are you?
Heidi, I'm sorry for giving you HIV and diarrhea.
It's okay.
Okay, I guess we're gonna cut that out of the video.
It's not okay, Junior!
Listen, Penelope, I have one question for you. If you answer this one question, me and Cody will drop out of the cheer competition and you'll never hear from us ever again.
Ever again?
I swear.
Fine, ask your question.
Okay, so Jay-Z has this song called Blanks in Paris.
I know this one!
Shut up, Heidi!
What is the name of this song?
I'm not saying the name of the song, Junior.
I just can't remember what it's called. It's Blanks in Paris. Is it Friends in Paris? Buddies in Paris? What's that word, Penelope?
I'm not saying the first word of that song, Junior.
Why not? Well, what is it?
I'm not going to say it!
Well, what is it? I mean, I just want you to say it one time and then I'll leave you alone forever.
If you say it first, then I'll say it.
Wait, if I say it first, you'll say it?
Yes, Junior, you say it first and then I'll say it.
Oh, that's easy.
Junior, I can't believe you actually said it.
I thought if I said it, she would say it.
You thought she was actually gonna say it?
We made a deal!
No!
She pulled a fast one on me.
No, she didn't pull a fast one. You're just an idiot.
You deleted that video of me saying it, right?
Yeah, sure.
Because I don't want to get canceled.
Right, of course.
Then I have to make an apology video. So look, we have to find a way to get them disqualified.
Junior, if we spent this time actually practicing, we might actually have a chance for beating them for real.
We have no time to practice now, Cody. Our only hope is to get them disqualified. So let me think.
Okay, what's your next idea?
I got an idea. If we get Penelope grounded, then her dad won't let her cheer in the competition because she'll be grounded.
Okay, how are we gonna get her grounded?
You leave that up to me.
No, no, I don't like it when you say that.
Her dad's a doctor, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna call him up.
Hey there, somebody call a doctor?
Hey, Dad.
Hey, Penelope, what are you doing here? I thought you were at cheerleading practice.
No, I decided not to be a cheerleader. I want to be a certified thot instead. Come here, Daddy.
I like this, too.
Well, I mean, you are getting older. About time this sort of thing happened.
What? No, I'm dating boys. Aren't you mad?
No, I mean, you're just getting to be that age.
Well, you know what? I'm going to go vandalize cars outside.
Well, just don't get mine. It's not insured.
Well, you know what? I think I'm just going to be homeless my whole life and do smack.
Well, I mean, I got to say, I'm pretty disappointed. I mean, as your parent, I wanted better for you. I mean, I'm a doctor.
You're a shitty doctor. Okay. Bitch ass, dumb ass, bitch doctor, bitch.
Okay, that actually hurt really bad. I try really hard. I just... You know, I try to be the best doctor I can.
You're not even a good doctor. You're not even a good father. You're horrible at it. You're bad. I hate you.
You know what? You know what? I think I deserve that. Yeah. Yeah, I haven't been a very good father to you, Penelope. I'm sorry. You know what? I'm coming to your cheerleading competition tomorrow night to support you. I need to be a better father. You're right.
I think you actually improved your relationship with your dad.
I want her to get grounded. This sucks.
You know, well, the opposite of that happened.
Okay, you know what? We have to go to the extremist of the most extremes. You know what? We're going to go break their kneecaps.
With what?
Yeah, we're going to grab a bat, and we're going to Tanya Harding them. We're going to break their kneecaps so they can't dance.
But, Junior, you said no physical violence.
Oh, screw that. I'm going to the most physical violence I could possibly go. Come on.
Hello and welcome to the elementary school cheerleading competition. We have two teams competing today, so let's introduce them. First up, we have the Powder Puff Cheerleading Squad. And oh no, here comes the boys. We have the Rowdy Rough Cheerleading Gang. First up to perform, the Rowdy Rough Boys!
Oh no, Junior, we're going first!
I wanted them to go first so we could break their kneecaps!
Junior, we didn't practice!
Look, we just have to go out there and do the best we can, come on! Okay, Cody, you ready?
No.
Just improv it. 1, 2, 3! Give me an O!
O!
Give me a B!
B!
Give me an E.
E.
Give me an S.
S.
Give me an E.
E.
Obese, your mom.
Okay, so I'm the judge, and I rate that a C.
You hear that, Cody? We got a C. So when the girls go on the stage, we break their kneecaps and we win.
But Jay, I think we should just be happy with our C. We might possibly win.
No, I'm breaking their kneecaps.
All right, next up is the Powder Pop Girls.
All right, Heidi, they got a C. That's really easy to beat. I know we got this.
Okay.
Come on. All right, Heidi, like we practiced. 1, 2, 3.
Ah!
Puff Girl's kneecaps. The Powder Puff Girl's wave.
We won, Heidi! We won!
Well, you guys won fair and square.
Get out of here, Junior!
Damn, who pissed in her panties?
Junior, you ruined everything. We still could have won. We had a flip in ours and they didn't.
Hey, Heidi?
Yeah?
Well, it turns out I got your blood test wrong. You don't actually have HIV.
Yay!
Penelope, congratulations on winning the championship. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you, Dad. I didn't know you showed up.
Yeah, of course I did. After what you said to me earlier, I decided I really need to be a better father. You know what? Let's all go to Chuck E. Cheese.
Okay.
Come on, Heidi, you too. It's wheelchair accessible.
Okay.
Virginia, looks like you actually did do some good. You helped Penelope with her father.
I just wanted to win. You saw how bad I wanted to win. I was willing to kill to win. I was willing to destroy everyone to win. They left the trophy behind, Cody. They left the trophy! That means we won! Whoever has the trophy won, right?
No, Junior, stealing the trophy doesn't mean you won.
We won! Celebrate.
With my eyes open, because if I close my eyes, I'm afraid that someone will come in and steal all my money. Hi, my name is Mr. Goodman, and welcome to a day in the life of me. I wake up every morning at 6 a.m., not because I want to, but because the sun is beaming through that window! Chives, close the curtain!
Very well, sir.
Chives, I made a stinky. I'm gonna need you to change me.
Very well, sir.
See, I don't get up to go to the bathroom, because that's for poor people. I just lay here and defecate in my pants.
That is one poopy butthole, sir.
Well, then pressure wash my ass, Chives!
How about a bath?
Sounds fantastic. You know how I like it, Chives.
Very well, sir.
Come with me to the bathroom.
Your bath is ready, sir.
Thank you, Chives. Every day I start my morning off in a bath of $15 million, all $100 bills. And I even take the bath with my suit on so it saves on laundry.
All right, sir, let's wash that tush.
You get down there, Chives, and don't forget your snorkel.
Very well, sir.
Oh, and Chives, can you turn on Tom and Jerry?
Sir, it's 6 a.m. Tom and Jerry isn't on.
Are you serious, Chives? There isn't a Tom and Jerry streaming service by now. My bath has been ruined. Go ahead and pull the drain plug.
Very well, sir.
And Chives, go ahead and make my breakfast.
Very well, sir. Your breakfast is ready, sir. Loaded mashed potatoes and a filet cooked medium.
Thank you, Chives. Chives?
Is there an issue, sir?
Where are my peppercorns?
We were out of peppercorn.
Spankin'!
Very well, sir. Thank you, sir.
Every morning I start my breakfast with a filet mignon cooked medium and loaded mashed potatoes.
Are you ready for your wine, sir?
What type of question is that, Chives? Pour it!
Very well, sir.
Thank you, Chives.
You're welcome, sir.
Chives?
Is there a problem, sir?
There is a speck of dirt on my wine glass.
I can assure you I just washed the glass.
Well, there's dirt on it.
Was that absolutely necessary?
Yes, Chives, because there was dirt on the glass. Now go to the store and get me new wine glasses.
But, sir, there are plenty of clean glasses here.
I don't believe you, because that one had dirt on it. Now go to the store and get me new wine glasses.
Very well, sir.
Now where is my maid, Quinceañera?
Mr. Goodman, my name is Patricia.
Whatever, Paprika. I spilled my drink and I need you to clean it up.
See, Mr. Goodman, I'll get right on you.
Are you wearing underwear?
No, Mr. Goodman, you're totally not done.
Good. This is my maid, Angela, and I got her pregnant 7 times because we don't believe in Plan B. Only Plan C, because the C stands for cash. We have the kids, I claim them on my taxes, and then we ship them off to Cancun or some shit.
Mr. Goodman, who are you talking to?
Talking to the camera because I'm making a documentary of my life. Now bend over and clean up that mess. I'm planning on having an 8th child. I wanted a nice view of my meal. Speaking of kids, where's my son Richard? Richard, get in here and eat your breakfast! What do you want, Dad? I was playing Fortnite. I was paying everyone to lose so I could win. Filet mignon again? I wanted lobster! If you want a lobster, you get your ass out there in that water and you catch one yourself.
I hate you, Dad.
I hate you too, son.
Dad, I see the maid's tush.
Why are you looking? You go eat somewhere else.
Okay, Dad, I'll eat in my room.
break that piece of shit.
So I've returned with your new wine glasses.
I'm not thirsty anymore, Chives. I would like to play golf. Fetch me my clubs.
Very well, sir. All right, sir, I have your balls and your club.
Chives, ew, there is a worm on my putting green. A worm, Chives.
I'm so sorry, sir. I'll remove him at once.
No, Chives, I want you to eat him.
Must I absolutely, positively have to do that?
Yes, Chives, I want you to eat him like a bird, like the white iris I have a painting of in my kitchen. How's it taste, Chives?
It's chewy, sir.
Yeah, I bet. Now watch me get this hole in one. Bitch!
Look, you made it, sir.
Yeah, I thought so.
You're so good at golf, sir.
Are you being a smartass, Chives?
No, absolutely not, sir.
You know what, Chives? Now go get it.
No, sir.
No, in outer space. Yes, in the water, because that's where I went.
But, sir, there are sharks in the water.
I don't. Oh, rats, fuck! You get your old geriatric wrinkly ass in that water and you get my ball. That was my favorite ball.
Well, maybe you should put that pitch in the wall.
Spank it! Now you get your ass in that water and you get my ball.
Very well, sir. Here, I am cracking your golf ball.
Now spit it in the hole, guys.
Very well, sir.
Hole in one. Now, boat time. Stolen.
Sir, you sent your boat out to be painted yesterday.
Well, then go to the neighbor's house and tell them I want to buy their boat.
But, sir, your boat would be back in 4 hours.
Spanking!
Why am I being punished, sir?
Because during my bath this morning, you didn't remind me that I didn't have boat time today.
Very well, sir. Thank you, sir.
Now I'm gonna go sunbathe by the pool.
Very well, sir. Shall I undress you for your swim, sir?
Ew! Chives, what is that at the bottom of my pool?
It appears to be a leaf, sir. Probably from the tree directly above your pool.
Well, I want you to jump in there and get it out.
But that's the pool boy's job, sir.
Well, now it's your job!
So shall I call the pool boy then and let him know he's fired, since I'm assuming his responsibilities?
No, I want him to show up and I want him to see you doing his job. That's how he'll know he's fired.
Very well, sir.
That leaf has ruined my swim time. I want you to drain the pool and clean it. I'm gonna go take a drive in my Lamborghini.
Very well, sir.
This is my Lamborghini. I buy a new one every week when the odometer hits 100 miles, because then it's just too used for me. Oh, Chives!
What do you need, sir?
Call up the airport and have my private jet ready.
And where are we going this time, sir?
I will be flying around for a few hours so I can think.
Are you sure you don't want me going with you in case you need some help, sir?
No, but what I do want you to do is fetch me Chimichanga or whatever the hell her name is.
I believe you mean Patricia the Maid.
Don't correct me, Chives! Spank it!
Very well, sir.
Chives, you go to your room and you stay there.
Yes, sir.
Chives lives in a little room under my stairs, like Harry Potter. I had to put him back in his room because he's been snappy today.
Mr. Goodman, why you need my help? The car already clean.
I don't need you to clean the car, Quesadilla. I need you to clean something else.
Oh!
My private jet. It's fast as fuck. Let me give you a tour of my jet. It's the most expensive jet in the world. All of the seats are made out of elephant asshole skin. This is where Chives flies the plane, his old ass. Wherever I touch on the screen, my private jet will take me. Snacks out the dick. The bottles of water come straight from Fiji. So I'm gonna go fly around for a few hours. I'll see you guys when I get back. Back from my flight!
Oh no, he's home! Oh no!
Oh, Chives, you can come out of your closet now!
Oh, yes, sir!
Alright, now let's walk around and do a house inspection to make sure you stay in your closet the whole time.
No, we don't have to do that.
Oh, we absolutely have to do it. Come on! Chives, did you touch my pool balls?
No, sir. You must have hit them before you went on your private jet.
No, I would have remembered that. When I left, they were perfectly wrapped right here.
Oh, how strange. Shall we move on?
No. You bend your old ass over this Brunswick label.
Very well, sir. Oh! Oh, more than one, sir!
Yes. How old are you again, you old fuck?
67, sir.
67 spankings it is. You stay in your room!
Yes, sir.
Old, crusty, man, ass cheeks. Alright, let's check my bank account to see if there's still four commas in there like there should be. Ah, yes. $1 trillion, just like it should be. Oh, Chives!
Yes, sir.
Has Marvin paid his house payment this month?
I don't believe so, sir.
Ah, let's pay him a visit, shall we? Now I'm at Marvin's house to get his house payment. He never has his house payment. Come on, let me show you.
Hello?
Goodman, what are you doing here?
I came to get your house payment.
Why is there a camera crew here?
Because I'm filming a documentary about my life. Now, do you have your house payment or not?
I don't have it this month.
All right, well, you're coming with me. Come on. All right, Marvin. Since you didn't pay your house payment, you're going to live under my stairs for a few days.
No, please don't make me do that.
Get in there.
What the hell? It smells so bad in there.
Because that's Chai's little room, and he has a little pot in there that he has to pee and poop in. And then every day, he's supposed to clean it out. And by the smell of it, he hasn't cleaned it out today. So get in there.
Please don't make me go in there.
Get in there.
Okay.
Now you sit in there and you think about what you did. Chives!
You called for me, sir?
I did, Chives. Tonight, you will have a roommate.
But sir, there's not enough room.
You will make his life hell like you make my life hell.
But I help you, sir.
Do you, Chives? Because I don't see a mimosa in my hand, and it's mimosa time. And you should know that without me having to remind you.
Here's your mimosa, sir.
Is the glass clean, Chives?
Of course, sir. I checked it twice.
Dare I look?
Go right on.
Chives, there is a fingerprint on my glass. A fingerprint, Chives!
Well, I can assure you it's not mine, sir. I'm wearing gloves.
Did you finger fuck my mimosa, Chives?
No, sir. Maybe it's your fingerprint.
Maybe it is. I'm sorry, Chives.
Don't worry about it, sir.
And I no longer want this mimosa, so I want you to stick it up your ass and come tuck me into bed.
Stick it where, sir?
Ass! Up it!
Very well,
after a long, stressful day, I like to have Chives come tuck me into bed. Chives, come tuck me into bed!
Very well, sir.
Thank you, Chives.
You're welcome, sir. Is there anything you need before going to sleep? Maybe a bedtime story?
Oh, yes, yes! A bedtime story, Chives! And make it scary!
Alright, sir. Once upon a time, you were born.
Ah! Too scary, Chives! Show me money! Show me that I have money!
Look, $100,
sir. Oh, that was so scary, Chives! Never tell me a scary story like that ever again!
Understood, sir. Is there anything else you need before bed? Maybe a lady for the night?
Oh, yes, Chives. A lady friend for the night, because I'm lonely.
And what is the budget, sir?
$30,000.
Ah, going cheap tonight, I see.
No, Chives. Actually, this is what I want. I want you to find a girl, have her shave her head, and wear a monocle like the Monopoly guy. Then I want you to take her to the hospital and have her legs amputated, because I want to know what that's like.
Ah, sparing no expense, I see.
Yeah, so... Go fetch.
Well, how about I just bring you the lady from last night, sir?
Fine, I guess that'll do.
Understood, sir.
Hi.
That was fast.
She never left.
Well, she smells too nice. You know what I want you to do? I want you to go outside and run 3 miles, but I want you to do it barefoot because I like the little black asphalt feet.
Okay.
Lock the door, Chives.
But, sir, how will she get back in?
She won't! I don't want dirty asphalt feet all over my 100% goose-down sheets. Ew!
But you're the one that told her to go run, sir.
I know, Chives, but you know what? Cancel it. Lock the door, but I want you to cuddle. Come here.
How about I just go get the lady, sir?
Big spoon me, little spoon you, Chives. I want to smell that dirty old man bald head of yours.
Understood, sir.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a day in the life of me. And that's just my off day. And make sure you tune in for when you see me go to work.
If you pop another balloon, you're grounded.
I'm not popping balloons.
Don't do it again.
That's it, Jeffy. You are grounded.
Baby, are you okay?
She sounds like SpongeBob when he needed water. I need water, Daddy.
What, baby, do you need water? Okay, I'm gonna get you some water. All right, baby, here's your glass of water. Take a sip. Is your voice better?
What? Your voice is still messed up?
Punch her in the throat.
What?
It'll make her voice better. Punch her in the throat.
No, Jeffy, she just lost her voice.
She lost her voice? Well, I'll find it.
What? No, Jeffy, you can't actually find it. It's not gone.
Jeffy is on the case.
She didn't run away, Jeffy. Her voice is just gone because, like, she can't talk. Listen, baby, I'm gonna call a doctor to fix your voice.
Hey there, did somebody call the doctor?
I just wanted a cool intro. Like, oh, okay, how about this? Introducing the doctor! Or how about this? Here's the doctor!
Can you just help me?
Oh, okay, what's going on?
My wife lost her voice.
Oh, yeah, she sure did.
Well, can you help her get her voice back?
I mean, it's not that serious. She just lost her voice. If she waits, it'll come back.
I know, but, like, I didn't know if maybe you had some, like, secret doctor things that could bring it back.
This is not really an emergency. You know, there's people having, like, heart attacks and strokes.
I know. Just, can you please get her voice back? It's really annoying.
Okay, I have an idea. You come with me to the bathroom.
All right, just come with me to the bathroom.
I'm gonna go see what they're doing.
Sucking on them because she thinks it tastes bad.
Oh, I thought something else was happening here.
Oh, what? You thought she saw my cock? You should have seen the look on your face. Can you imagine the lawsuits? Oh, I'd be so screwed. Let's see if the cough drop worked. Oh, dang it, it didn't work.
So what are we gonna do now?
Hold on, just let me think. Stupid. You're a bad doctor, just like your father said you would be, you idiot.
No. You're not a bad doctor. Look, there's gotta be something else we can do for her voice.
The cough drops were my only idea.
Come on, you can think of something.
Okay, you're right. Yes, I have an idea. Come on. Okay. Now, just gargle that before it gets cold.
What is that?
Oh, that's boiling salt water to help the throat.
No, you're supposed to gargle warm salt water, not boiling water.
Oh. Stupid idiot doctor. God, I'm so stupid.
Well, no, you're not. You just didn't know.
Yes, I am. I'm an idiot. Ugh, let's try something else.
Yeah, we'll just try something else. Do not try that, baby.
I don't know what to do now.
Listen, you're a doctor. You went to school for this. There's got to be something you learned about getting people their voice back.
Hold on. Let me check one of my medical books. I use it all the time. It usually helps. I don't see how any of this is supposed to be helpful. The big ones hurt, you know, because it's so big. Mine doesn't hurt. Girls, they like that. The U.S. national average is 5 inches, so I have less than that. That makes me special. So you're boring if you have a 5-inch wiener. Mine is travel size. Like, it doesn't get in the way. It's very convenient. You know, I can wear sweatpants and you can't see it. But, hold on.
Oh, I got the wrong book. I'm so embarrassed. Stupid idiot doctor with a tiny penis.
No, it's okay.
No, it's not okay.
Well, actually, according to the book, it is okay. It's totally fine. It's normal and you don't have to worry about it. But I'm gonna get my phone and look this up.
Okay, just looked it up. Look, right there, it says national average 5 inches.
Can we please help my wife with her voice?
Oh, right. Hold on, let me just Google that.
Oh, yeah, it's called laryngitis.
I knew that.
Oh, good. Steps to get your voice back. Step one, avoid talking. Shut up, bitch!
Okay, step two, moisten the throat. Hey, Marvin, maybe we should take it back to the bathroom, huh? You know what I'm saying?
I'm just kidding, that's your wife. Okay, step three, eat hot food.
Oh, that's easy. I can get some hot food. Just hold on.
Okay, I got some nice cold ice cream. Fuck! Damn it, it's supposed to be hot food! Hot food, not cold food! You stupid idiot doctor! God, I'm so fucking stupid!
No, what is wrong with you?
What is wrong in your stupid fucking brain?
No, it's okay, I promise it's okay. Everything's fine.
Okay, I'm good now. It's just, is it hot in here? I feel hot. I feel hot. Turn your AC on, I'm pissed off.
I'll turn the AC on, go get some hot food.
Okay, get hot food.
I'm gonna turn on the AC.
With what? Mommy's voice! Where is it?
I don't know, Jeffy.
Okay, I'm still looking for them. My webs don't work.
Jeffy, just go away.
Okay, here's your chicken schnoodle, Snoop.
Fuck!
God, why am I like this? What is happening to me?
It's okay, you just misspoke.
Yeah, I know. Oh, God, I'm having a bad day. I'm just gonna help you, and then I'm gonna go home.
Yeah, that'd probably be smart.
Here's your spoon.
Buddy, it's okay. Buddy.
I'm sorry.
Listen.
Just eat this. Here's your spoon. Just eat it. It'll make you feel better.
Look, just go clean yourself up.
Okay.
Baby, you want to try some?
Hey, I cleaned myself up. I took a shower. I hope you don't mind. I didn't have a change of clothes, so I put on her bathrobe. It kind of fits, but I mean, you might see a ball or two. But that's okay, because we're bros, right? You know, I saw a lot of balls in the locker room in college. That's actually why I got this book, because I got really insecure after I saw all the sledgehammers they were working with in there. Then they all laughed at me and called me Tiny Wang Brookie. And I was like, it's cold in here. And they were like, no, it's not. You're taking a hot shower. Anyway, I pissed in your shower. I hope you don't mind.
You peed in my shower?
Yeah, but I was just trying to save you water, but not using your toilet. At least I didn't poop in your shower like I do at home.
You poop in the shower?
I said I didn't poop in your shower. I mean, I had to, but I was going to wait till I get home to poop in my shower.
Why do you poop in the shower?
Hey, you're already getting clean, right? What's the fun of using the bathroom and then having to wipe? You're already in the shower. You can just wipe your butt in there and clean it off, right? It's a one-stop shop. And then you can just, like, wash it down the drain with the shower head. It's like a little video game. You wash the poop through the holes, and then you just waffle stomp it down. But I don't have feet, so I just kind of waffle punch it. But you're already getting clean, so it's fine.
I think it's time for you to go.
No. I would not be doing my job if I gave up halfway. What if I was doing an open heart surgery and I gave up halfway? Somebody would die.
But it's just her voice. It'll come.
No. I said I would help, and I'm gonna help. Hey, kid, you shut up. You zip it. You hush. You put a sock in it. Pipe down. Put a lid on it. Bite your tongue. Shut your trap. Quit your yapping. Not another peep. Shut your pie hole. Put a cork in it. Cállate la boca. STFU. Stop talking. Good. Okay. Now, I don't actually know what to do next. What? Oh. Someone's at your door. Hold on. I'll get it. Find me, Kindle Kid. Hello?
Hey there. You're on the hit TV show. Can your wife say literally anything? Man, I love this show. I watch it with my wife all the time.
What's going on?
It's a TV show called Can Your Wife Say Literally Anything? All the wife has to do is say any random word, and you win $1 million and a trip to Fiji.
What? That's insane.
Yeah, but most people screw it up because they're too shocked that they're on TV and they mess up, or the wife just isn't home. But we can do it because your wife is here, and all she has to do is say a word. Oh, no, Marvin, tell her.
Oh, no. Okay, baby, I know you lost your voice, and I know you can't really talk, but I need you to go deep down, really hard, just try really hard to just say one single word, and we win $1 million, okay?
Okay, man, get in front of the camera. No, that was more of a noise than a word. Sorry, you lose.
Fuck, God damn it, we'll never get this chance ever again.
No, baby, you couldn't say just one word. Oh, my God.
Oh, that's it. I've had it up to here. No, I've had it up to here. That's how far I've had it up to. I am so tired of her not having a voice. I'm pissed off.
I know.
It cost us $1 million.
We could have won $1 million. Could I ever be back on the show?
No. Once you're on the show once, you're never allowed back. They never come back to the same house. The show is so easy, they gotta make it hard somehow.
Oh, darn it. I wish you could just fix her voice.
I know what I'm gonna do.
What?
Throat surgery.
No. That's way too invasive. I don't think we should...
No. I'm not letting her voice beat me. I've had a hard day, and I want to win. I'm gonna cut open her voice box and put in another one. Come on, we're doing surgery.
No, but baby...
Okay, the surgery was a success. I cut open her throat and I stuck an Apple Watch in there.
Why'd you put an Apple Watch in her throat?
To help her talk.
Well, can she talk?
Oh, yeah, we can make it talk in any voice we want with this remote. Check it out. This is Elmo.
Well, do I sound like Elmo? I don't want to sound like Elmo.
Why don't you change your voice?
Okay, well, how about this? It's Mr. Meeseeks from Rick and Morty.
Can you help Rose get her normal voice back?
Give her a normal voice back.
I don't know if a normal voice is an option. What about this one?
Mom, why do I sound like an old man? Can you tell this man to give me my normal voice back?
Is that the old man from Family Guy?
Yep, that's what that is.
Just give her normal voice back.
I don't know if I can. What about this one?
What voice is this?
She sounds like the gingerbread man from Shrek who knew the Muffin Man.
Wait, you know the Muffin Man?
The one who lives on Drury Lane?
Well, she's married to... the Muffin Man!
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
Huh, she's married to the Muffin Man.
Eat me! What?
Ew, why'd you spit on me?
Okay, listen, can you just give her normal voice back, please?
Listen, you're just gonna have to get used to these silly voices. I don't think her real one's coming back.
Dang, dang, dang! I think I know where Mommy's voice went.
Well, where'd it go?
After a long and tireless investigation, I, Inspector Jeffy, have come to the conclusion that the voice actress for Mommy is out of town.
Wait, she's out of town?
Yeah, look who's playing Mommy.
Wait, so she's not even here? So that's why you haven't sounded like yourself, because your voice is even here.
Wow, did all this for nothing.
Yeah, we didn't even have to do all this surgery and all this dumb stuff. We could have just not used her in the video.
Don't I feel stupid?
This is so dumb. Thanks for watching, everyone.
Yeah, everybody, thanks for watching. Shit, God, I'm stupid. I did this stupid doctor with a tiny penis who broke the shell.
It's okay.
I'm so stupid.
All right, Jeffy, no more stickers.
Well, I got one more flaw.
My face is already covered.
That's what she said.
Come on, Marvin. Just let him do it.
Okay, hurry up.
There you go, Maddie. Flog.
All right, no more stickers.
Yes, more stickers. I got one more.
No, Jeffy, put them on your body.
All right, I'll put them on my butthole. Therefore, when I fart, stickers go everywhere. It'll be a sticky fart.
Just still have the door. Hold on.
Hello?
Hey, Marvin.
You have any health pay for this call?
Well, no, I don't have it.
Well, so you don't have enough money to pay me, but you have enough money to buy stickers to put them all over your stupid face.
Well, no, my son had the stickers.
Listen, Marvin, I don't care. I'm tired of you being poor. So you know what I'm going to do? This is your nutsack. If you don't have your house payment tomorrow when I come by, this is what I'm going to do to your nutsack. What your nuts, Marvin? I'll just hand it to Marvin.
Okay.
Marvin.
It's Goodman, and he wants my house payment, but he's just so mean.
Don't worry, Marvin. He's just a mean rich man. He doesn't understand.
I know, but he doesn't know what it's like to be poor. I just wish he knew what it was like to be poor. I'm gonna go wash these stickers off my face.
Uh-oh! Not to wipe your stickers!
Come on, Jeffy. Let's get ready for bed.
Okay.
Good morning, Rose. Rose?
Who's Rose?
Ah, who are you?
My name is Starlight. We met last night.
Well, I don't remember that. I have to get my bag. Rose is going to be so mad.
Good morning, sir.
Who are you?
I'm Chimes, your butler. What? Hungover again, I see.
No, I'm not hungover. What are you talking about? I don't know what's going on.
Sir, your name is Goodman. You're a trillionaire, and you're a dick.
I'm in Goodman's body?
Yes, sir. You are Goodman.
I don't know what's going on.
Sir, shall I pay the lady for her services?
You owe me $5,000.
I don't have $5,000!
Sir, yes you do. It's right here. Now scram!
Thank you.
Okay, listen, Chives. I don't know what's going on. I'm not Goodman. I'm not supposed to be in my body.
Ha ha ha, very funny, sir.
No, I'm telling the truth. I'm not Goodman. I don't know what's going on.
Shall I just bend over for my spanking now?
Why would I spank you?
Normally when I talk back to you, you give me a harsh spanking.
I don't want to spank you.
What? I think I love you. Shall I draw a bath, sir?
Yeah, I'll take a bath. That'll help me figure out what's going on.
Very well, sir.
I'm good, man. Look at all this money in the bed. What the? Well, I've never seen this much money in my life. I really just bathe in this?
Yes, sir. It's all yours.
Do you want to join me?
Really, sir? I've never been allowed to join you before.
Yeah, jump in. The money's warm.
Very well, sir.
Taking you to school? I don't even know who you are. Is this Marvin's house? I must have fallen asleep here.
Marvin, did you fall asleep on the couch again?
Ew, fat!
Marvin, you're so silly when you first wake up.
Why do you poor people keep calling me Marvin?
Because you are Marvin.
Oh no! Ah! Bald and poor!
What's wrong, Marvin?
I'm bald and poor!
You say that every morning.
I used to be handsome, but what happened?
You fat cow!
Moo!
Here's your breakfast, sir. Filet mignon cooked medium and a loaded baked potato. Unfortunately, we don't have any peppercorns.
Why
Why are you showing me your butt?
So you can spank me, sir.
I said I wasn't gonna spank you.
Really?
Yeah, this breakfast is amazing. Do you want some?
Oh, I'm not allowed to have any, sir. Normally you just feed me kibble without the bits.
No, you can have some of my steak. I'm not gonna eat all of it.
Really, sir? Thank you so much.
Dad, can I drop out of school and become a piece of shit?
Yeah, sure.
Really? You're the best dad ever! Yay! No school!
Sir, I don't know what's gotten into you, but we love it.
Yeah, I think I love it too.
Ah, why did this happen to me? Why am I in Marvin's poor, fat body? I bet he's got a tiny wiener. Let me check. Tiny wiener! Why would God do this to me? I'm such a nice person. Wait a minute. If I'm in Marvin's body, that must mean he's in my body. I gotta call him and get my body back.
Marvin, I think we should file for divorce.
I think so too. You're just too fat.
What?
You're a fat cat. Give me my phone. I need to make a phone call.
Okay, here. Fine. Go call your other girlfriends.
I think I might. Come on, me. Answer the phone.
Ah, this is the life.
Another glass of champagne, sir.
No, thank you, Chives. You can have that glass.
Wow, thank you, sir.
Man, Goodman's life is amazing.
Sir, you're getting a phone call.
Just put it up to my ear.
Very well, sir.
Hello?
Marvin?
What? Goodman?
Are you in my body?
Yeah?
Yeah, because I'm in your poor, short, fat, small wiener body. You have a small wiener, do you know that?
Yeah, but listen, you have a big wiener, and I like your life, it's so amazing.
I know my life is amazing, so give me my life back.
No, I think I'm gonna stay in your body for a while.
No, you give it back to me right now.
The call's breaking up.
That call is not breaking up, because that is a satellite phone.
Chives, hang up.
Chives, don't you hang up on me! Huh? He hung up on me! Oh, if I ever get back in my body, I'm gonna make Chives walk around in a thong and I'm gonna give him 1,000 spankings!
Marvin, I made you some breakfast. I think you just woke up cranky.
It better be filet mignon!
Ew! What is this? Albino rabbit shit?
It's Cheerios, Marvin, made with real honey!
Where's my filet mignon cooked medium rare? Peppercorn!
No, we can't afford that, Marvin.
Ew! I keep getting more and more and more!
I'm gonna go to my mansion and see if I can get my body back.
He's going through a midlife crisis!
Marvin, you open this door right now!
Hello?
Chives, let me in my house.
Yeah, I'm sorry, sir. I was given strict instructions not to let Marvin into this house.
But I'm not Marvin. I'm Goodman, so let me in!
Well, you certainly look like Marvin.
Chives, as soon as I get back in my body, you're getting a spanking.
Well, hopefully that never happens. In your body right now treats me great.
He treats you great? That can't be happening. Marvin, get down here right now!
I'm sorry, sir. If you would like an appointment with Mr. Goodman, you'll have to call in and schedule it in advance. Unfortunately, he's booked by about 3 years. Good day, sir!
Chives, don't you slam the door in my face!
Oh, man, this house is incredible. I could just lay here and relax all day.
Excuse me, Mr. Goodman. I was wondering if maybe I could start wearing underwear now because it's getting kind of cold in the house.
What? Why don't you wear underwear?
Because you told me not to wear underwear.
Why'd I do that?
You know, for like easy access.
No, you can start wearing underwear. Definitely, you can start wearing it.
Really? Let me thank you.
What are you doing?
I was going to thank you.
You can just say thank you. No, I can give you a raise.
Oh, you have a raise? Let me help you.
No, I meant like a raise with money.
Oh, you're going to pay me?
I don't pay you.
I mean, you start that though, but it's only like 5 pesos per month.
Okay, I'll start giving you $3,000 a month.
Really? Let me thank you.
No, I said I know what the thank yous look. I'm gonna go drive around in my car.
Do you want me to thank you in the car?
No, just stay right here and do whatever it is you do.
Okay, Mr. Goodman.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
See you later.
Oh, wow, a real Lamborghini, and I get to drive it. This is so cool. Oh my God, I've never driven a Lamborghini before. Let's start it. Oh, this is so cool. Okay, I'll drive really careful. Man, I love driving this car. I never want to go back to my old life. Goodman!
Marvin, you get out of my car right now!
I'm sorry, Goodman.
Your joyride is over. Take me back to your house so we can figure this out.
Okay.
dig it.
All right, Marvin, we're gonna sit right here and figure out how to get me back in my body.
Oh, hey, Marvin, I see you brought your lawyer, too. If we can just sign these papers, we can get this over with real quick.
Wait, what's going on?
Marvin's wife is divorcing him.
Why?
Because he keeps calling me a fat cow.
Is she not? I'm doing you a favor, Marvin. I'm gonna sign those papers.
Well, no, we don't want the divorce.
Well, it's not really up to Marvin. She's divorcing him.
Well, maybe we can work something out.
Well, I made it really easy for you. See this happy little font? It's called Fairy Tale Ending. I know it's kind of ironic given the circumstances, but imagine if it said divorce in big red letters. That'd be pretty sad. But this is like divorce. That's not so bad.
Okay, but Marvin doesn't want the divorce.
Oh, come on. Look, man, I know that divorce is scary at first, but after you get divorced, you can download Tinder and then get a piece of strange ass. And then you itch for the next few weeks. Post my clarity's a bitch. But then you find another woman, and you get married to her, and you do it all over again. It's a circle of life.
Okay, but listen. I'm not Goodman. I'm Marvin. Goodman's in my body.
It's true. I'm bald and poor.
What?
Wait. So you're telling me you switched bodies like some kind of Rob Schneider movie?
Yes, and we don't know how to get back in our bodies.
Well, that explains why Marvin was so mean to me.
Yeah, I would never be mean to you, baby. So does anyone have any ideas how we can switch our bodies back?
Well, in the movies, usually they miss their old life and learn a lesson, and then they switch back.
Yeah, I miss my old life. I miss being rich. I want my body back.
Well, I kind of like Goodman's life. So, I don't know. I mean, I guess I miss my old life. But listen, can you like, help us figure this out?
Look, man, I'm in lawyer mode right now, not magic mode. I don't even know how to do magic. This is a problem you gotta take up with God.
Hey, it's me. What's going on?
God, we need your help.
Yeah, I know. I heard.
Okay, so me and Goodman switched bodies. We don't know what's going on.
Yeah, that was me. I drank a lot of water last night, and I accidentally turned it into wine. I got pretty drunk. I thought it'd be funny to make you guys switch bodies.
Well, can we switch back?
Well, that depends. Did you learn your lesson?
What lesson was I supposed to learn?
Well, maybe now that you've seen how terrible Marvin's life is, you'll treat him better from now on.
I agree. It is pretty shitty. He's poor and he's married to a cow.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm talking about. So you're gonna treat him better now?
I guess I'll treat him slightly better.
Okay. Poof!
Oh, am I back? Am I back in my body? Hold on, let me check. Oh, yeah. I'm back. Big wiener in town. Ha ha! Poor! I mean, slightly less fortunate. You know what, Marvin? With all the crap that you've been through, you don't have to owe a house payment this month. But I would recommend signing those papers.
Thanks, I guess.
Marvin, is that really you?
Yeah, I'm back in my bald, fat body.
Don't forget your small wiener.
Yeah.
Marvin, at least we have each other.
Okay, well, while you guys do that, I'm gonna go have my maid thank me.